this MEA weekend, kind of the last official summer getaway camping vacation weekend. But today we will hear Jesus' parable of the Pharisee and the tax collector, both demonstrating two very different kinds of piety. In prayer updates, I got a couple today. Nicole and Travis King had twins about 2 weeks ago. It was on October 5th, so it was almost 3 weeks now. They had a little bit of a setback with one of the twins. Archer, I think he was born first, was diagnosed with meningitis. And this past week, he was transferred to Children's Hospital in Minneapolis. So please keep this family, new family, in your prayers. I haven't had a recent update in the last 24 hours, but last I heard, he's still there and he's being treated. 3 weeks old for meningitis, which is very serious, so please keep them in your prayers. Some other updates. Sherman D'Souza's family, his brother, William, died, and his funeral was this past week in Pipestone. I talked to Jane, and she said, thank us for remembering them in the prayers. Dwayne Richards' niece, Sherry Fell, died this past Tuesday. It was unexpected. She was diagnosed with cancer, but only like 3 weeks ago, so it was very quick for her. There is a graveside service for her this coming Tuesday. More information about both of these deaths can be found on the Harpist website. And I think that's probably, the other. Edna Ballard fell at home Friday night? Yes, Friday night. Was transferred to the hospital in Marshall. Broken hip. Has already had surgery. I got there at about noon yesterday and she was already back from surgery. 101, 102 years old. I can't believe that she was sitting up and feeling better and thanked me for not coming Friday night because she didn't feel good. She felt good yesterday. I think it was the drugs. But Edna's recovering. She said she'll probably have some rehab. But she's going to go back home at some point when she can get herself around a little bit better. But quite a surprise. So keep Edna in your prayers. Just feeling good. Any other prayer updates before I go on? This week, we have quilting on Tuesday. Next Sunday is Reformation, and we kind of, sort of as a rebellious kind of thing, try to wear red. Just perk things up a little bit. So if you have something red to wear, wear that. Today, at starting at noon, I think there's 12, 1, and 2 time slots. We're going to do a food packing event over at the Rock. Several of youth and adults have already indicated that they'll go over and help pack food. So we've got that going on this afternoon. Any other announcements? Seeing none, let us continue with worship. Please stand if you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is eager to forgive, who loves us beyond our days. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. God of mercy and forgiveness, we confess that sin still has a hold on us. We have harmed your good creation. We have failed to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with you. Turn us in a new direction. Show us the path that leads to life. Be our refuge and strength on the journey. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and Friend. Amen. Beloved of God, Your sins are forgiven and you are made whole. God points the way to new life in Christ, who meets us on the road. Journey now in God's abiding love through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our gathering hymn, Spirit of God, descend upon my heart. It's in your red hymnal, number 800.
Thank you. The first reading is from Jeremiah 14, verses 7 through 10 and 18 through 22. Although our inquiries testify against us, act, O Lord, for the name's sake. Our apostasies indeed are many, and we have sinned against you. O hope of Israel, its Savior in time of trouble, why should you be like a stranger in the land, like a traveler turning aside for the night? Why should you be like someone confused, like a mighty warrior who cannot give up help? Yet you, O Lord, are in the midst of us, and we are called by your name. Do not forsake us. Thus says the Lord concerning this people. Truly they have loved to wander. They have not restrained their feet. Therefore the Lord does not accept them. Now he will remember their iniquity and punish their sins. Have you completely rejected Judah? Does your heart loathe Zion? Why have you struck us down so that there is no healing for us? We look for peace, but find no good, for a time of healing, but there is terror instead. We acknowledge our wickedness, O Lord, the iniquity of our ancestors, for we have sinned against you. Do not spurn us for your name's sake. Do not dishonor your glorious throne. Remember and do not break your covenant with us. Can any idols of the nations bring rain, or can the heavens give showers? Is it not you, O Lord, our God? We set our hope on you, for it is you who do all this. The psalm will be read responsibly. You'll read the bold. Psalm 84, verses 1 through 7. How dear to me is your dwelling, O Lord of hosts.
My soul has a desire.
Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest, where she may lay her young, by the side of your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
Happy are they who dwell in your house. They will always be praising you.
Happy are the people whose strength is in you, whose hearts are set on the pilgrim's way.
Those who go through the
They will climb from the height to height, and the God of gods will be seen in Zion. The second reading is from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 6 through 8 and 16 through 18. As for me, I am ready, already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. At my first offense, no one came to my support, but all deserted me. May it not be counted against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the message might be fully proclaimed and the Gentiles might hear it. So I was rescued from lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil attack and save me from his heavenly kingdom. To him be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Here ends the second reading.
Use your mic. Use your podium mic. Use your podium mic, please. We can turn it on. Oh. Turn one of them off.
Regarded others with contempt.
Oh my.
It's totally off. Okay. Jesus also told this parable to some who trusted in themselves, do not trust the sound system, that they were righteous and regarded others with contempt. Two men went to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee, standing by himself, was praying thus, God, I thank you that I am not like other people. Thieves, rogues, adulterers, even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give a tenth of all my income. But the tax collector, standing far off, would not even look up to heaven, but was beating his breast and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his home justified rather than the other. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, but all who humble themselves will be exalted. The Gospel of our Lord. You may be seated. I'd like the children with us to come up front. I need you to be kind of close today because I'm going to need somebody to help hold the microphone. Someone to just sit kind of close. Who wants to hold the microphone? Right beside me. Okay. On this side because I'm going to have to hold it right here. Now, you guys, as you're thinking, just hold it right like this. You hold it there? Good. Because you want everybody to hear. What little holiday's coming up? It's not really an official holiday, but it is for kids. Next week, what? Halloween. What are you going as? A what? A vampire. Oh, Maverick from the new Top Gun movie. What are you guys going for? Come closer. What are you going for Halloween as? A ninja. A football player. A superhero. See, they already got it figured out. Well, I got a couple things here I'm going to show you. And I want you to step, tell me if this works. Now, don't say anything, okay? Close your eyes. Okay? Oops. Just put one hand here so it doesn't slip. Yeah. I want you to tell me if this makes me funnier. Does this make me funnier? Does it? Do you think God will think I'm funnier? You do? I think God will see me the same no matter what I am. Okay, close your eyes again. Close your eyes. Both were praying. Okay? Okay, thank you.
was shouting, saying, "Oh God, I am so good to you. I give my offerings, I come to church, I do all these great things. I am such a good Christian." And the other one was saying, "Oh God, I'm a sinner. Don't look at me. I'm not doing good." Both of them were worshiping, okay? But God says, you don't have to do all that stuff. I see you for who you really are. I see your heart. So when you come to church, you don't have to do anything special. Or when you're out in public, you don't have to shout or scream or do anything special. I love you regardless. So when you go, just be, let your heart love God. That's the important part. Not what you do to tell people that you love me. Let your heart tell me. That's a good message, isn't it? So it's not the things you put on. It's fun for Halloween to dress up and pretend I still love God. Oh, I'm going to cry about it. It's fun to dress up, isn't it? But you're not really that person. It's just for the day. Okay, let's come close and pray. And have lots of fun. And by the way, the pastor has chocolate candy bars. So I'm just saying, if you stop by my house. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, for reminding us it's not what we do in front of you. It's not how we pray. It's the fact that we just do it. And it's the love that we have for you in our heart. That's what matters. It's not how we look or how we stand or where we go. But you need to know that we love you with all of our heart. Amen. Good job, guys. And have fun, okay? Now I have to do this one-handed, so be patient with me. I titled this Humility or Grandiosity. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and redeemer. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. When my daughters were in middle school, during confirmation, Wednesday night worship at Lent was part of our routine. This happened one year when we began Lent with the usual Ash Wednesday service that included the imposition of ashes. Each person goes forward and receives that mark of ashes on their forehead as a symbol of their own mortality. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust, earth to earth, you shall return. It's repeated to each of us. It's a humbling moment when our own mortality is right in front of us and we can do nothing but bow our heads in reverence. Once a year, on the way home, the girls always seem to bring a couple friends with them, and they asked if they could stop and get a slushie at the local 7-Eleven. So we stopped, and off they went to get their favorite treat. When they returned to the car, they were chattering about their experience that they had just had. The clerk was from India and asked them why their faces were dirty. They went on to explain that they had been to church and receiving ashes was a part of worship. The question back to them then was, what good does it do to walk around showing everyone what your religion was? Wasn't faith something between you and God? The girls were thinking this because the same gospel text was the one assigned on that Ash Wednesday, as it is every 3 years. Why did we go in public with ashes on our forehead? It was in that moment I was grateful because Lutherans have Ash Wednesday worship in the evening. So normally we just go
though that's not true everywhere. In the news, people everywhere are shown with ashes as early as noontime on that day. Yet on the other hand, here are 14-year-olds speaking to a non-Christian about their faith, explaining what they had done as part of their faith practice. And there was something brave on their part to be able to do that without being self-righteous about it. Could the public display of ashes lean towards that grandiose side of religion, the side that Jesus warned against in this parable? Maybe. That passage always reminds me of another one that Jesus said related to the expression of our faith. It's from Matthew 6. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in synagogues and on street corners to be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father, who is unseen. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. Community worship does not necessarily need to be taken to the street, as personal prayer does not necessarily need to be done in public either. There are times and places for both. But for believers as individuals wanting to proclaim their faithfulness or devotion to God, doing that in public comes off as being self-righteous, and it casts a shadow of sinfulness onto that person trying to demonstrate their faith. I have one more example of where this same rule is a little fuzzy. Alexa was our fourth granddaughter. We lost her to cancer in 2011. When she was four, we all, as a family of eight or nine, went to dinner at her favorite place, Applebee's. And when the food finally came, this child stood up on the bench and shouted, "All right, people, it's time to pray," at the top of her lungs. She grabbed the hands of those sitting beside her, which we always did as a family when we prayed, and a hush fell over the restaurant. Then she said again at the top of her lungs, "Do it, Mama." I was embarrassed and I was startled that this child had the power to quiet down an entire restaurant full of people. Well, I prayed and I did it short and fast. One sentence. Thank you, God, for this food and all our children. Amen. Everyone went back to their meal as if nothing had happened. And everyone at our table took a breath and just started to eat. Was that being grandiose or self-righteous on a four-year-old's part? I hardly think so. But what it did do was it humbled us and those in the restaurant. And maybe that's all the difference that we need to know and recognize anytime we are in public and we worship or pray. Jesus said, "All who exalt themselves will be humbled, but all who humble themselves will be exalted." By the way, as a bit of irony, the very next passage in this Gospel of Luke is where the children are brought to Jesus. And he tells everyone that the kingdom of God, that they must become, in order to have it, they must become like little children. Faith is not the physical acts that you perform. perform in front of others. Faith is letting God's presence change you. Amen. Change My Heart, O God. It's in your red ELW number 801. Rescue families and nations torn apart by violence and warfare, especially those living in Ukraine. Unite all people towards common goals of reconciliation and peace. Hear us, O God. God of hope, you stand with suffering and give strength. Comfort your people filled with fear or anger, anxiety or shame. Bring healing to all who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, especially we remember Edna, Richard, Sherm, Dwayne, and John, and Archer. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of hope, you stand with the suffering and give strength. You call us to trust in you and not ourselves alone. Make our congregation a place of humility and repentance, ready to encounter you in love and following your ways. Guide us in service and in love in your name. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of eternal life, to you be the glory forever. We give you thanks for all who have fought the good fight, for all of our loved ones that we remember on this day, for those who have finished the race, kept the faith, and now live with you. With grateful hearts, we commend our spoken and silent prayers to you, O God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Also with you.
Let us share God's peace with one another.
Peace be with you.
We'll continue with the offering.
Thank you.
Gracious God, in your great love, you richly provide for our needs. Make these gifts a banquet of blessing. Make us ready to share with all in need through Jesus Christ, who set a table for all. Amen. Let us now pray the way our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our closing hymn, Let Us Ever Walk With Jesus, in your red hymnal number 802. Trinity, one God, guide you always in faith, hope, and love. Amen. Amen. Our Bible hymn is in the back of your hymnal. It's a little piece of paper, "Go Now in Peace." Should look like that. If you need one, the ushers have extras in the back. Thanks be to God.